In this After Effects tutorial, let's see how to create this awesome looking fast food slideshow animation in After Effects. This is gonna be super easy, so without any further ado, let's jump right into After Effects and get started. Alright guys, so this is Adobe After Effects and let's start by creating a new composition. It's very simple, just go to composition, take a new composition, and this is gonna be our main composition, so I'm gonna call it main. I'm gonna use the size 1920 by 1080, frame rate 60, duration make it 5 second long, background color black, hit OK. And now let's create a white background first. So just go to layer, go to new and take a new solid layer. Select the color pure white, I'm gonna call it BZ01 because this is gonna be the first background, hit OK. And now let's place the background right over here. So hit P on the keyboard to bring out the position property of the background. Hold this background and move it right over here. And then we have to animate the background. So just go to 1 second, click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the position property. Go to very first frame of this animation. Hold this background and move it on the left hand side. Just like that. Highlight both the keyframes. Hit F9 to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor. If your graph editor not looking like this, then right click on that, click on edit a speed graph. Just place the CTI on the frame number 20, highlight this point and drag it on the left hand side. Just like that, you can place this over here on the frame number 20. And now let's have a look. So we have smooth animation as you can see. Now you can close the graph editor. Let's create a duplicate of the background. So select the background, hit Ctrl D to duplicate. Just go to effect and preset and search for ramp. Let's apply the gradient ramp on the second background. Now let's change the animation. So hit U on the keyboard to bring out the active keyframes. And then just place this CDI on this keyframe. Hold this background and drag it on the left hand side, and we have to place this background in the center just like that. And then just go to very first frame of this animation. This time we have to place this background on the right hand side, so it's very simple. You can drag the background and place it on the right hand side outside of the frame. Now we have nice and smooth background reveal, and then we have to change the color of this. So select the gradient. Here we have the first point and the second point, so I'm gonna place the first point right over here. After that we have to select start and the end color. I'm gonna use two different color code for two different colors. So first of all, we have to select the start color. Just click on the color. Here we have the color code option. I'm gonna type this color code over here, hit OK. Now select another one. I'm gonna use this color code for the end color and then hit OK. After that, we have to add noise over here. So just go to effect and preset and search for add noise. Let's apply this effect, add noise, on the second background. Here we have to change preview to final output. This is the intensity and size. So I'm gonna set the intensity 0.6. size 0.5. open the animation and let's turn off the animation. You can see here we have animation on the noise, but we don't want this noise animation. Simply set the animation speed 0. And then we have to create phone layout animation. It's very simple. Just go to project window and let's import some assets over here. Right click on the project window, go to import file and select these files. Click on import. You can download all these files for practice from the link given in the description. And after that, just drag and drop the iPhone layout into the main composition. Hit S to bring out the scale property. You can scale it up just a little bit. I'm gonna set the value 150%. And then we have to animate the iPhone layout. So what we have to do, hit P on the keyboard to bring out the position property. Just go to 1.5 second. Lock the position as it is by clicking on this stopwatch button. Just go to very first frame of this animation. Let's drag the iPhone layout just like that. Now we have this type of linear animation. Highlight both the keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor, Highlight this point, hold this handle and drag it on the left hand side, and now we have nice and a smooth animation. You can close the graph editor. Then what we have to do, just select the iPhone layout, right click on that, click on pre-compose. Here we have to select this option, leave all attributes in main, give it a name, iPhone, hit OK. And then you can open this composition. Here we have to create a perfect phone layout. So create a new solid layer. So just go to layer, go to new and take a new solid, select the color pure white, hit OK. You can place the white solid below this phone layout. Select the white solid, select the paint tool, and let's create a mask around the phone just like that. Perfect. And then we have to add a brand logo over here. So this is the logo. Let's drag and drop into this iPhone composition. I'm going to set the size 6% maybe. And then you can place the logo right over here. This video is not sponsored. I'm using this logo just for reference. And then we have to create a same color at the bottom. So select the background, hit Control D to duplicate. Now let's change the solid color. So you can hit Control Shift Y to open the solid setting. Pick this color picker and pick this color from logo. Click on new and then select the solid color. Select the rectangle tool. Let's create a rectangle just like that. And then here we have mask 1 and the mask 2. So just go to mask 2 and change this add to subtract. And now we will get something like this. You can close the layer and then you can add a text right over here. So simply select the text tool, go to character, select any font style that you like. In this case, I'm using Bebas New Pro. Set it to regular, set the size of the font 30 pixel. Click over here and type order now. You can type anything whatever you like, and then select the move tool, place this text in the center just like that. And then you can go to the main composition and here let's add a drop shadow effect on it. So just go to effect and preset and search for drop shadow. Let's apply this drop shadow on this phone layout and then just go to effect control and do some settings. So first of all, let's set the opacity 25%. This is the softness. I'm gonna set the softness 100, distance 10. Now we have a nice and simple drop shadow. And after, let's add burger png. So just go to project window and let's import the burger png into this main composition. First of all, we have to pre-compose this. So just right click on that, click on pre-compose. Change this option, move all attributes into the new composition. Let's call it burger, hit OK. Now hit S to bring out the scale property. Let's scale it down. I'm gonna set the size of the burger just like that, maybe 35%. And now let's attach this burger with this phone layout. So it's very simple. Select the burger. Here we have the pick whip. If you don't have this pick whip option, you can click on the toggle switches and attach this pick whip with this iPhone. Now we have the slide up animation on this burger as well. And then let's add drop shadow on this burger as well. So select the iPhone, go to effect controls, select the drop shadow effect, hit Control C to copy, select the burger, hit Control V to paste. Now we have the drop shadow on the burger as well. Now you can close the layer and let's add more animation on it. So just go to something around frame number 30, which is equal to half a second. Select the burger, hit S to bring out the scale property. Click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe on the scale property. Go to 2 seconds. Let's set the size maybe 50%. Perfect. And then just go to 3 seconds and let's set the value 45%, I think. Perfect. And now create a smooth graph. So highlight all the keyframes, hit F9 to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor, just place the CDI at 1 second, highlight this point and let's drag these handles just like that. Perfect. Just place the CDI at 2 seconds and 20 frame and create over here. Perfect. Now you can close the graph editor and here we have the animation something like this. And after that, let's add more elements. Just go to project window. Let's drag and drop the vase item inside of this main composition, just like that. Select the pan behind tool, place the anchor point right over here, and then we have to create scale animation. So select the wedge, hit S to bring out the scale property. Just go to 2 seconds, click on the stopwatch button to create a keyframe. Set the scale value 60%, go to 1 second here. Let's set the scale value 0. Now we have something like this. After that, highlight both the keyframe, hit F9 to ease them. Go to your graph editor. Here we have to place the CDI at 1 second and 20 frame. Highlight this point and let's create a pick. Perfect. And now we have this type of animation. I'm gonna place the vest item right over here. Maybe you can close the graph editor, hit R to bring out the rotation property. I'm gonna place the wedge just like that, and then just place the wedge below this burger, and now we have this type of animation. Perfect. Let's create a duplicate of this wedge. Hit Ctrl D to duplicate. I'm gonna place the second copy right over here, hit R to bring out the rotation, and let's rotate just a little bit and place it over here. Now we will get something like this. After that, we have to add some text over here. So select the text tool, go to character, select the font style Bebas New Pro. You can use any font style that you like. I'm gonna set it to 300 pixel, line spacing 260 pixel. Click over here and type burger. Hit Ctrl A to highlight all, go to paragraph and click on the left align. And after that, we have to animate the text. So open the text. Here we have the animate, click on the animate. Select this option, position. Click on the add button, go to property, add the opacity. Go to add again, go to property, and this is the tracking. And here we have the position X and Y. So I'm gonna set the Y position 200. Opacity 0%, tracking amount negative 60. Perfect. And open the range selector, go to 1 second and 45 frame. Set the start value 100%, turn on the stopwatch button, go to 45 frame and set the start value 0%. Perfect. Now we have something like this. After that, highlight both the keyframes, hit F9 to ease them. Go to your graph editor. Here, just go to 1 second and 15 frame in between both the keyframes. Highlight this point and create nice and simple graph. And now we have smooth animation, as you can see. After that, you can close the text layer, close the graph editor. Let's create a duplicate of this text by hitting Ctrl D on the keyboard. Here, let's down the size. I'm gonna set the value 75%. Let's type fresh and tasty. Hit Ctrl A to highlight all. Just go to style and set it to bold. And after that, let's change the color of the text. So select the second text layer, click on the color and pick this logo color just like that. Hit OK. And after that, let's change the animation style for this text. Just open the text layer, open the text. Here we have the animation one. Let's delete the tracking amount first and tracking type as well. Open the range selector, open the advanced. Here we have the based on character. So let's change this character to words. And then we will get something like this. Select the text, hit U to bring out the active keyframes. Just place the CTI at frame number 15. Highlight both the keyframes and place it right over here. After that, you can place the burger text below this burger or wedge layer, just like that. And now let's add one more text over here. So it's very simple. Select the text tool. And after that, let's create a duplicate of the text. So hit Ctrl D to duplicate. Type the second line, which is off. So here we have 20% off. Perfect. And now let's animate the text. So it's very simple. Select the rectangle tool. Let's create a rectangle like this. And then I'm going to use this rectangle as a mat. So select this one, click on rename, and I'm going to call it mat, hit enter. Now select both the text, go to track mat. If you don't have the track mat, click on the toggle switch edge and change this track mat to mat. And then just go to 2 seconds and 50 frame. Hit P to bring out the position. Click on the stopwatch button to lock the position value. And then just go to 1 second and 20 frame. Drag the text outside of the frame just like that. Now highlight all the keyframes. Hit F9 to easy ease them. Go to your graph editor. Highlight these points. Drag it on the left hand side. And now we have nice and simple smooth animation. After that you can close the layer. Close the graph editor. Now let's create a time gap between both the lines. So select the second line, hit U to bring out the active keyframes, highlight both the keyframes, and now move it 15 frame forward in time, just like that. Now you can close the graph editor. You can turn on the motion blur. So click on the toggle switch edge, and this is the motion blur button. Turn on the motion blur for all the layers. Go to full screen and let's have a look. Absolutely amazing, right? And that's a wrap for this tutorial. If you have any question or thoughts, feel free to drop a comment below. And if you are new to my channel, consider subscribing and giving this video a thumbs up. My name is Vikas Kumar, and I will see you in the next one. Till then, bye bye.